What's good, YouTube? This is your boy RJ back with another video for you guys. And it's been a minute since I've made some content in regards to 2K. Now, I know this year's 2K of 2K21 that we're on, I pretty much mentally could not play it. You guys see me. I started off with it well, but you know, once qualifiers and a lot of stuff of controversy has happened over the times of playing that game, seeing people using Zens, hearing people using Zens, and yeah, I'll get into a bit more in another video in regards to why with that. But this video is to talk to you guys about next levels of coming into NBA 2K22. Now, even though this is going to be off kind of topic of what I'm going to be saying, is because there has been some information that was released that I just want to talk about, and I just want to talk to you guys because I ain't talked to you guys in a minute, right? So, with that further being ado, speaking about the 250K tournament, now with my team, we know how 2K is. 2K loves the money. You know, we love money, but 2K loves our money. You know what I'm saying? We put our money into the game. We put our work into the game for them to give us back a $250,000 tournament. Now, before I get into the video, if you guys are new, drop the subscribe, show the love. We bring you content back with it. Also, hit the thumbs up button and just comment down in the section below. Have you pre-ordered 2K22 yet? There hasn't been no big news yet, but have you pre-ordered 2K22 yet? But when we get into the scenes of right here, the big 250K tournament. Now, I know this is a screenshot of when I was in the tournament, as you guys can see on the left side, C3 at the bottom. But my thing is, I didn't qualify last year. Well, I didn't qualify this year, I should say. And I didn't qualify because, you know, it has got competitive. And that's a great thing. You know, I love to compete. But the biggest thing for me is mentally, I could not play. And like I said, I'll get into another video, explain a little bit more in regards to why I stopped taking it serious. But just talking about the 250K tournament. Now, on each side, PS4 side, Xbox One side. Now, with the new gen that has been released, a lot of people has got the new gen. A lot of people still are trying to get it. 2K has decided within 2K21 that they made the current gen, which is understandable because they pretty much released the next gen console like a little bit before the 250K tournament. So I can understand why they did that. Now, going into NBA 2K22, what I want to see is I want to see them actually making this tournament for next gen. I'm not sitting there saying it's fair for the current, but what I'm saying is make it for the next gen. The biggest thing for me though is that seeing how much money that 2K has made, it's just mind-boggling. Because when we look at what Madden had just released their tournament information in regards to they're hosting they do it almost every year though, a $1 million MCS tournament. Now, that's pretty much the Mutt side. That's their Mutt gameplay, their Mutt tournaments of my team is what it'd be for 2K for us. My thing is how I broke it down on my tweets. Follow me on Twitter, by the way, is what I was pretty much saying. Now, you see how 2K is $250,000. I'm going to show you guys pretty much the Mutt side so you guys can get a glimpse of what that's looking like. So when we look at it here, they have four different types of qualifiers. That's what this is. This is four different qualifiers. We got the ultimate kickoff, the ultimate Thanksgiving, the ultimate wild card, and the ultimate Madden Bowl. So pretty much all of these is just qualifiers, man. Like first place to eighth place, you can win some bread between, you know, September to September 8th. $150,000 prize pool. You win 40 racks, 25,000, 15, third or fourth, fifth through eighth, $10,000. Online elimination phase, both consoles, first to fourth, advance to the live finals. So it's like my thing is seeing how consistent, how they're giving back and so forth. Now, I can't really break down too much of the information with Madden because I'm not too big. I don't play Madden. I mean, I may play it just a little bit just to have a little fun, but just seeing what they're doing, it looks like they have four different quals, or if it's four different tournaments, I may be wrong, but more than likely it looks like it's four different qualifiers. Because what I believe this is advanced to the live finals. I mean, is that going to the bowl? Like, because it'd be 4-8-12. No, that can't be. So I'm just curious how this works. If you guys know a little bit more, let me know. But my biggest thing to talk about this video is seeing how much money that they're investing in to put them back out to the community. They have $1 million. They broke it down into different type of events for people to make money. Even if you are in eighth place, you can get 10 grand. Top eight, get some bread. You know what I'm saying? 15,000. 14th place in the Ultimate Madden Bowl gets 30 grand. So the thing is, it's like seeing a competitive side, not only through Madden. Like, I understand this. What this does is this makes people spend money, right? You know, people have to spend their bread to get their team to what they want to be. With NBA 2K, same outcome. The only difference is we're waiting for that first weekend, that second weekend. We're pretty much waiting each month for that one weekend to qualify. I can make another video talking about qualifiers. What do I wish how qualifiers would be? Let me know in the comment section below as well as what else you want to see me talk about in the upcomings of NBA 2K22. But my biggest thing right now is talking about the $250,000 tournament for 2K. How I feel like they should do it. They should kind of like break it up, you know, if they want to, you know, keep it competitive, because we're all waiting to try to qualify for one tournament, for one game mode throughout the whole year, because they don't drop any other tourneys. There's a couple off companies that would host tournaments, or streamers as is myself that I would host tournaments to try to keep the community going live with doing these things, being competitive, and we would do that. That's fun. But the thing is seeing that other side of competitiveness, and that 2K cares in regards to keeping the My Team community afloat, because you see how the Pro-Am community is. They have the NBA 2K League. Like, yeah, you got to go through trials and tribulations to get to the 2K League, or to get to the draft, to get drafted. You know, it's just like saying playing in real life basketball. You know, you got to try to make it to the combine, to be good in the combine, to get drafted to a team. Now, the biggest thing is, like I said before, is I just want to see a bigger side of 2K giving back a little bit more. Even if it is them trying to break down $250,000, that's still giving back a little bit more to other people that are out there that's competing to play in the game, and not only paying their money to put into the game to play for you guys. But I will say that to either A, you guys made, we seen it, $860 million. We seen it. Y'all can raise that bread up. If it is going to 500K or 750, y'all can raise that up, break it down. Nobody's saying you got to give it all to one person. I mean, if that's what you guys like to do, obviously we see with the 250K. They tried to do that. They actually did that this year. Recently, Ty Debo splashed. They were in the top two. Ty won his bread. Well, he won, what, 150? Or did he win 250? I think he won. No, he won 200. So Ty won 200K. Splash took home 50K. So they broke it down into those aspects. Like, they're trying to see how they can, you know, widen and expand to say, hey, let's give back to, you know, more people than just the top two. Because years before that, it was one person get that bread and the next person get a console, go home, goodbye. But now it was, you know, they did it, which is, I found that was cool. You know, they gave Splash 50K. They gave Ty the whole bread, the rest of the bread, out, you know, first place. And that's how it should actually go. But I just want to talk to you guys about that. Let me know in the comment section below how you feel about the community of, not to the community, but more so what you guys think that they should do with the $250,000 that they expanded. Of course, we all wanted it to expand, bring it more. Or if they can't, or if they're not, do you think they should break it down even more into multiple groups of tournaments? So that way it gives us a more type of opportunity to compete and exposure and so forth. Or you feel like it's good where it's at. Let's all have fun and go from there. Until next time, to another video, make sure you like, subscribe, comment. It's your boy RJ in the building. You dig.